And joining us on WHKY TV News is Scott Reilly, the District Attorney for the 36th Prosecutorial District. Thank you so much for coming in, and we always appreciate you giving us the report for the past month, and it has been a busy month in the office, hasn't it?
It has been. It's my pleasure. Thank you for having me. Yes, we have had a busy number of months, actually. We're coming up on our 6 month in office, and I think everything is going very well, and I'm very proud of our assistant DAs for the work that they've been doing and resolving a lot of old cases and giving closure to victims who have been waiting for justice for, in some cases, 6 years.
Yeah, a lot of murder cases you wanted to talk about, and one actually resolved last week from 2013, but there are a number of other cases that have been really sitting there and you've been waiting to get to those.
Right. When I took over in January, there were approximately 50 pending murder cases, and unfortunately, a lot of those cases did have substantial age on them. There were a number from 2013, and we have resolved all of the cases from 2013. Just last week, Nancy Austin was convicted after a two-week jury trial. She was convicted of first-degree murder and received a life in prison sentence, which is the automatic sentence for first-degree murder, but I was most happy that we were able to give closure to the victims who have been waiting for, you know, 6 years on that case.
And there are other cases, and you're going to be dealing with those as well, correct?
Yes, there's a large number of cases still from 2016. Those are on our priority list. Next week we have an administrative court where we will be scheduling trial date certains for those cases. So hopefully after next week we will know what cases that we can finish up this year and the beginning of 2020.
What else did you want to talk about? I know, you, like I said, you have a lot going on in the office right now.
Right. We've talked about the LEAD program and trying to give help to low-level drug offenders, people who have substance abuse problems. We are trying to bend over backwards to give those persons whatever help we can do with incentives and resources and drug treatment. But on the other hand, we are really trying to aggressively prosecute the people, the persons who are bringing these drugs, these opiates in and selling them, trafficking them, distributing them to our young children, and we are aggressively prosecuting them. And if somebody happens to give a opiate to someone and they overdose and die, that person will be charged with second degree murder. That is how seriously we are taking these cases. And with the number of cases, number of overdoses that we have just learned about that occurred in Caldwell County over the Memorial Day weekend, I am more committed than ever to aggressively prosecute people who traffic opiates and give them to our young children.
We are about out of time, but I guess I'll maybe send the viewers to your relatively new website. You've got a great website now.
Yeah, I'm very proud of our website, and it is a great place for anyone to look on our Facebook page or our website to see what's going on in court, to get victim information, find court dates, see how to pay your traffic ticket. So any of those things, go to CatawbaDA.com.
It's a great site and a lot of information. Thank you for coming in. Always good to see you.
Thank you very much.
Scott Reilly, our District Attorney, 36th Prosecutorial District, joining us this evening, as always, with his monthly report on WHKY TV News. Back to you, Ralph.